got everything set, ready to go, then it's time to bait everything up. Once I have everything baited up, I try very, very hard to keep all of my cord where I put my rod down. So I mean, I've got Anna's Bloody Tuna, some Kokanee Special, I've got some sand shrimp, I've got some Berkeley Gulf Maggots, I've got some super sauce, I've got it all right here on my little bait tray, and I'm trying to keep everything good to go. So I'll start marking things on my graph. Once I have it marked on my graph where I'm seeing a consistent line of fish, I'm saying to me, myself, this is the thermal comfort where there's the most amount of oxygen in the water. That thermal climate is very, very important because that level of oxygen is where those fish are going to be the most active. So, of course, if they're more active, what are we trying to do when we're catching cocoa? We're trying to piss the fish off is what we're doing. Okay, cocoa are very finicky fish. And like I said, I was fishing with Bob Lomas this morning. And this was my side of the boat. Bob was fishing over here. Ed was in the back BSing with us. This side of the boat was hot. This side of the boat wasn't. And there were small variations as to why. This rod was by far, hands down, probably the best rod of the day. I kept it a consistent 50 feet where I was finding the fish. Bobby would drop down to 50 feet and he would have a certain rigging on his rod, kind of the same setup that I had. He wasn't getting fit. So if he wasn't getting fit at 50 feet, he was running the same rigging that I had. What do you think would be the reason why he wasn't catching any fish?
Speed?
Well, if you're going to speed, we're all going the same speed, but dive faster, right? The other thing that I did is lengthen this clip, right? Now, if you have it, this shuttlehawk, forward bob Shasta tackle, I looked at it and I'm like, well, it's a stacking tool and I don't like the stack, so I'm not gonna use it. But then when we bought the company, I kind of needed to know how to use it. So we just did a video on it, I've been playing with it, and it's absolutely, you know, a phenomenal tool. Because I very, very rarely will go out fishing alone. So typically I'm running at least six rods in the boat. The way I do that is I've got a rod holder here and I've got a rod holder here. And I'm gonna stack off these two downriggers. I'm putting the bobber stop 10 feet above my first line. And like I said, you know, on all my downriggers, I like that spread to be about 10 feet each. I'm going to smack this up onto the downrigger cable. I'll take the line and twist it. Twist that line. Twist that line just like this. About eight times. And I'll take the little clip here. I'm going to put it in the back. And I'm just going to push down on it, out, as I put it in my hand. But I'm going to push down in it until I hear a pop. Now, I've got this line in the clip. But what I like about it is that this clip is actually adjustable. So, based upon the diameter of your line,